Uncle Vladimir was bad enough, but when I was 10, my parents abducted me to Canada. Okay, it was a healthy life and I learnt lots of useful things, but when we moved back to England, my street credibility was minus zero.
Jesus! It's Nanook of the North.
Antonia! Hi!
Antonia McGill. We'd known each other since birth. When we were 3, she knocked me unconscious with a milk bottle. When we were 5, she buried me alive in the garden. When we were 7, she formed a secret society and wouldn't let me join. Needless to say, I worshipped her. My uncle was a fascist. My formative years had been spent in a canoe. I was looking to Antonia McGill to pull me through.
You know, the thing to remember about the Canadian constitutional crisis, it's linked to an even thornier issue. Of the Canadian identity. Pierre Trudeau, the Prime Minister, says that having America for your neighbour is like going to bed with an elephant. They give him a standing ovation for that remark. The Canadians, I mean.
Nanook of the North.
Butch?
Honestly, Jane, what did they teach you in Manitoba?
They taught me to breathe. Human beings need oxygen, Antonia. That's what they taught me.
They're always a bit tight at first.
No, I need a bigger size.
You're not trying a bigger size.
Antonia, why is what I wear so important to you? You're embarrassed to be seen with me. She doesn't want people to know I'm her friend because I wear a duffel coat.
Well, clothes are important. Clothes are key.
Clothes are key, are they? What about the war in Vietnam? I thought that was supposed to be key. And putting a stop to racism. And hunger. And third world misery. No, isn't that key as well? Not to mention nuclear disarmament. And finding a cure for cancer.
Janie, cool it.
I am cooling it! Now just pretend you don't know me. Now, I don't want to spoil this key image you've created for yourself. It's just I have better ways to spend my time. Now you'll all have to excuse me, because I have some really key things to do now.
After that, I sort of retreated from reality for a couple of years. I got very interested in the theatre. The theatre of the 1930s.
Looking very lovely in this damp, moonlight Amanda. Your skin is clear and cool, your eyes are shining, and you're growing lovelier and lovelier every second as I look at you. You don't hold any mystery for me, darling. Do you mind? There isn't a particle of you that I don't know, remember, and want. Glad, my sweet. More than any desire in the world, deep down in my deepest heart, I want you back again. Please.
Then I went through a religious phase. I joined the Russian Orthodox Church. Which really upset my parents. After that, I tried Zen minimalism for a couple of months.